So I found out that I made a big mistake when it comes to the amount of transactions with Dash. The data that I found on that website is not correct because Dash, you can also send Dash via mixing coin join feature, and that way one transaction will show us three transactions or so, two or three, I don't know how many, but more than one on the blockchain. And so somebody said that is into Dash that even though it shows today like 11,000 transactions, it's probably more like 3,000. So that's what I did, and I basically had to divide it by three the amount to get to around 3,000. I put it a little bit higher and not to be subjective about it. Because this whole exercise is only for me to see if Bitcoin Cash, BC Hash, is still a competitive investment. That's why I make this, because I saw the amount of transactions go down a lot. And especially after the fork in November, it just was cut in half. And so it looked like the split off of BSV pulled quite some transactions away. So I wasn't sure if BCH was still a good investment. Also, there were these stories about Dash that they are doing very well in adoption in Venezuela. So I really want to check the numbers, and that's why I make this video and the previous one. But I think I improved the short a little bit one a little bit better, or this sheet here. So I think this is more valuable video than the previous one. Because I start measuring now not from a random date in February, but from the absolute market peak when the market was peaking out at 850 billion US dollars. Then 850, that was on 7 January, and then these were the prices. Of course, the coins themselves have peaked at other prices. Bitcoin Cash peaked, I think, a couple of weeks before or after at 4K. I mean, it's not that these are the peak prices, but this was the day of the market peak, and so when most coins were valued on average the highest. I did remove Ethereum here. I don't show it anymore because it's of no importance. You can't compare Ethereum with Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash and Dash and Monero because Ethereum is a crypto platform. It's not a cryptocurrency. It's a crypto platform, and the token Ethereum or Ether is used for often machine-to-machine transactions. And so if you want to do a comparison, you need to look at Ethereum versus EOS and versus Tron and versus crypto platforms. And I'm personally like not interested to invest in crypto platforms because it's just too complicated for me, and it's not my area of expertise. I really want to focus on cryptocurrencies that are peer-to-peer, human-to-human. I believe that that's where I really want to invest my time and money in. And so if you look at the top 20 or top 10, let's say top 20 from all the coins that are in the top 20 today. So here is the market peak of 850 billion of January the 6th, or 800 billion here. These are weekly averages, but I took January the 7th. It's about the same. What was I saying? Let's look at if Bitcoin Cash is still competitive. So I cut Dash transactions by three, but I cut them only by two here in at the market peak because I suppose that during bull times there was much more speculative transactions also for Dash, and so it's not really like very few transactions were about real utility, like real merchant payments. And so it's only when you do real payments to other people, I think, that you will use this kind of mixing service. Or yeah, maybe you also do it when you send to exchanges, but I think I'm just guessing here. Please correct me if I'm wrong, that the mixing feature is going up over time. Also, like during peak times when Dash was expensive, then of course, if you do mixing of transactions, then you're gonna pay also more in transaction fees. So I think right now that's much less of an issue than at market peaks. So I divided it by two here and not by three. And that means that Dash indeed still has the does have a correction in amount of transactions, not a rise. But of course, that would also be the case if you divide it by three. Let me just also do it by three. So if you do divide by three, both of them, then the correction is the least in Dash for amount of transaction. Is very positive news. It's a great achievement. It's actually less than Bitcoin, and Bitcoin has done very well because it bottomed out at about 170,000 transactions in January. This was market peak, but 2 or 3 months later, it had collapsed to 170,000. But now the past 8 months or so, it has climbed up again gradually to 270,000. So this is also very good performance. And I have to admit that if you look at these statistics, that Bitcoin BTC is doing much better than I would have expected. For example, Bitcoin Cash has continued to go down in amount of transactions the whole year. And that's why it has also the biggest correction in amount of transactions. But that's not the case with Bitcoin BTC. It only corrected for a couple of months and since then has gone up, and these are on-chain transactions. In addition, you also have the Lightning Network starting to be used. That's not counted here. So this is very positive news for Bitcoin BTC, and it's undeniable. Also very unlikely that these are fake transactions, because a Bitcoin transaction these days cost 20 cents. So you're not going to fake too many transactions. It's a costly affair. So, if you look at US dollar cents, corrections are strong. We can't do that for Monero. But the other ones show that it's about the same, and they all correct a lot in amount of US dollar cent. And so not all also Bitcoin Cash compared to the peak in my previous video at a random date in February, and then well, the correction was not so much, but now we see that it's also a lot. It's the same as how much the price has corrected. Also amount of US dollar cent has also corrected equally, which is in line with expectations. It's only Bitcoin here that sees like only a correction of 80% up until today, or this is from that day, but actually amount of US dollar cent has corrected a lot more. And Dash, and then we have median transaction value. They all corrected a lot, the same. So that's correct and in line. And then if you look at the metrics here, if you divide it, so the price per transaction actually for Dash was even more expensive at the peak than Bitcoin Cash. And Monero and Bitcoin BTC were valued equally. And right now, after the big correction, we have all of them, or all of Bitcoin Cash and Monero are the most expensive per transaction. BTC comes then, and the cheapest one is Dash per transaction. So when you look at the amount of transactions, Dash is the best buy today, and also has corrected by far the most. It was the worst buy at the peak, and today it's the best buy. If you look at the amount of US dollar cents, actually Bitcoin was still relatively cheap at the peak, but Dash was very expensive. After the correction, we see that actually Bitcoin is still expensive. It has become a lot more expensive if you look at the amount of value that's sent over the network. And that's interesting, isn't it? This could suggest that actually this number is not real and is fake. I think that's possible, because even though it's costly, to do fake transactions, it can certainly be profitable still. I mean, if you want to attract Bitcoin investors to Bitcoin, BTC, this is what, this is a very important metric to show to investors. And Bitcoin BTC is managed by a Blockstream, a company that is trying to build a second layer on top of it, Lightning Network. But of course, if Bitcoin BTC becomes unpopular and stops to attract big investments, then of course the Lightning Network will be in trouble. So actually, because the amount of Bitcoin, the amount of value sent over the Bitcoin network has collapsed the same as the other coins, how is it possible that then the amount of transactions has not collapsed at all, like the value? I don't understand that. I also don't understand, like, who is doing more Bitcoin transactions today compared to like 6 months ago? Half or more of the people that use Bitcoin, I mean, 90% plus does not use Bitcoin. BTC, actually, most of them support the idea that it's a store of value, not to use somewhere. So these people have, like, the last 6 months, like, almost, like, do 50% more transactions today. I don't understand that. The interest is a lot lower today in Bitcoin BTC. The amount of people that are out of Bitcoin BTC have given up on it is very high. At least half of the people that used it half a year ago are not there anymore. So how come the amount of transactions has gone up so much? It's not like there is any application that's built on top of Bitcoin BTC, like some kind of popular game of some kind of popular gambling website that I know of that is starting to have a lot of transactions. We're not in Satoshi Dai's times here, where Bitcoin BTC was very cheaper transaction, and you had all kind of apps being built on top of it that started to do a lot of transactions. Like at the time, it was the case with Satoshi Dai's, but today not. So this actually is a contradiction if you look at these two numbers. And it does, but anyway, if you only look at this number, Bitcoin BTC is not a good buy today compared to the peak. It has become more expensive, and Dash is a bad buy, and Bitcoin Cash is still the same. The value, like from this perspective, the price you pay for Bitcoin Cash is the same today as in when it was peaking. The price has corrected as much as the amount of US dollars sent. Median transaction value is the most important metric because it's really much harder to fake. If you even have, like here, let's say you do like 70K transactions per day are fake, then still you're not gonna, like, and that means that it's like 25% more transactions than in reality. That means that the median transaction value is not manipulated by 25%, but maybe only by 5% or maximum 10%. So what happened here? Well, it's the same as the amount of US dollars sent. It corrected equally all three coins. And so, yeah, that's believable. That's believable. So the only thing that's really not, like, this is all believable. US dollar cent median transaction value that has gone down all about the same. It's only that, like, the amount of transactions is so different. For Dash, it has really, like, not collapsed. And that's surprising, but it's possible because they have been working a lot. They have a lot of, like, they have double or triple the amount of merchants than they had at the peak. They really have worked hard on merchant adoption. So it might really have slowed down the collapse in amount of transactions. That's possible. But also for Dash, that does not show an amount of US dollars sent over the network that has collapsed as much as the others. So, I mean, it also does not show here that median transaction value has collapsed as much as the others. So I don't know. I am skeptical. I'm skeptical of this number and of this, the amount of transactions for Dash and for Bitcoin BTC. I'm not sure these are can be taken serious. But anyway, that's what we need to do. Like for me, the conclusion is that for me, the conclusion is that Bitcoin BTC or Bitcoin BCH, yes, it's very bad to see such a strong collapse, but it's actually very questionable that these coins have not seen such a strong collapse. This is actually probably correct. XMR has also has collapsed less than Bitcoin Cash, but also seriously. But that's believable. And XMR does very well. Monero, they have real utility. They are really used on dark markets. So that makes sense that they collapsed the least. So yeah, I do think like Bitcoin Cash, even though the amount of transactions collapsed a lot, if you look at the other metrics, it's in line with Bitcoin BTC and Bitcoin and Dash, the collapses. And so therefore I think we must not be like, look, especially negative of this. This is normal that you have 80% less amount of transactions during a bear market. We have to look not negatively to this, I think, but we have to look skeptically to these two numbers, because that's hard to believe. At the time I saw the same at Dogecoin. The amount of transactions are clearly fake in Dogecoin. If you just look at the amount of transactions here since the start for Dogecoin, it's just ridiculous. Let me just show that. Oops, okay. We have all-time Doge here. When Doge started trading, that's here in 2014, it launched at the start of at the peak of the bubble. You had a lot of transactions here, but there was no growth of transactions. Like it always went down, basically. That's like, how is that possible? How can a coin that just launches have more transactions the first 2 months than after half a year when it was much, much more popular? Because Doge, in the beginning, also not so many people knew it. And so there's clear manipulation, of amount of transactions. You have to be careful for that. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching.